Welcome to the Fweebs podcast, where basically we talk about whatever the fuck we want because we do whatever the fuck we want. That's right. Our show is all about keeping it real, going off topic, being unfiltered and raw while sharing our own experiences and life stories. Join us weekly as we help remove your boredom one episode at a time.
What's up, Fweebs?
What's up, Fweebs?
What's up?
That's my go of being a STEM today, you know, it's the West Coast, East Coast mashup, you know, the confidence with the chill vibes.
Let's
you know?
Go, Fweebs.
What's up, Fweebs?
I like it.
I can't take it seriously. All right, so we have so much to talk about on today's episode.
I'm Tiff.
Oh, yeah, and I'm Gotti. We always forget that. You guys should know our names by now. It's episode five.
Come on, you already know the name.
You should know our names. It's how.
Just a reminder, though.
Just a reminder. Today, we're going to be talking about the ultimatum teaser. And what we are also going to do is a blind reaction to another podcast that Tiff and I thoroughly enjoy. And when we saw this kind of show up on the live feed, we were just like, we have to talk about this
It's really funny.
So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to watch the teaser together. We're going to explain the teaser because for us in the queer community and for us that have kind of been on board with what's going on, we know what we're talking about. But for other people in the audience that have no idea what we're even talking about when it comes to the ultimatum, this is kind of for you guys. We're going to break it down a little bit and then we're going to do the blind react and we're going to take it
from there. Because there's a lot of people that aren't into reality dating shows.
I was not one of them.
Yeah. And I wasn't one of them either.
Yeah.
Until I was on one. I did watch Love is Blind, though.
Now you're in the damn.
I did watch Love is Blind, though, during the shutdown.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
The shutdown. All right, guys. So stay tuned. Let's get it up.
I don't even want to say her name anymore. She's like Voldemort to me. The experience was 10 people coming here, meeting other people who you could find something with. What did you come here for?
Hello, everyone. Hello. You're all here because someone in your relationship has issued an ultimatum. Each of you are compatible with multiple people here.
Someone here could be a good fit for me.
I am ready to spend the rest of my life with somebody.
But I'm not ready to commit to marriage.
So I gave an ultimatum.
Either I leave here engaged or we're done. I want to get married to this person. I want to bring children to the world with this person.
I don't want permanency. I don't want stability. I want freedom.
I want to live with you for 5 years and then I'm open to it.
I don't want to go into a marriage having these issues. If you don't like my dog, you can get the fuck out.
Sometimes you can't see when the person is right in front of you.
Baby. I just want to be close.
You came in here with an ultimatum. You knew what you wanted and now you don't.
You can't have us both.
Let me find somebody who's ready.
You said you wanted to marry me, but you fell in love with someone else in a week and a half.
You wanted me to figure out what I wanted, and I did that.
I wanted you to find out if that was me.
You were trying to stir the pot.
She's playing with our life.
I didn't do shit.
What do you want from me?
This is too late. This is absolutely too late.
This situation is just fucked up.
Trash.
Sometimes love is not enough.
Trash.
Trash. I love it.
All right, well, that was fucking intense, I will say. And I've seen the trailer or the teaser a bunch of times, and it just still kind of like the same bitches piss me the fuck off. And then I still feel bad for the same other two bitches where I'm just like,
oh my god. What's your first reaction on it? Like for someone
when I
that's
first saw it, I was just like, I watched it. And I was like, first of all, I wasn't into reality TV. Like, I've seen a couple of reality TV shows here and there. When I saw it, I was just like, damn, this is something I would binge watch. Mm-hmm. Like, just because, A, it is queer, and then the representation that I think that I saw on the trailer kind of, like, got me excited. It got me thinking, like, okay, cool. Like, it's not just, like, white culture. Like, mm-hmm. there's a lot of diversity.
Yeah.
There's, you know, there's black and brown people. There's Latinas. Like, it just...
White is the minority.
Yeah. And it's not to say anything bad about white, but like, you know, like me, I'm like probably the worst lesbian ever. I just watched the L Word, 30. So like I was kind of looking at it like, okay, yeah, there was one Latina, but like it was a lot of white culture representation. And all of the other queer shows out there other than like RuPaul are real white, you know? Like
what I love about it is, I think with 10 people, there is about as much representation as there could be.
Oh, 100%.
There... is Black, there is Latina, Afro-Latina, mm-hmm. Asian, Native American, uh-huh. non-binary, Jewish, femme mask.
Okay.
I mean, I think there's like everything you can think of.
Phenomenal.
Almost.
So, all right. So let's explain the show because, like I said, I'm not into reality TV. I did see The Ultimatum 1 only because when I saw this trailer, I was like, damn, I got to watch The Ultimatum 1 to understand what I'm getting myself into because I would not understand the rules. And I didn't want to be that person. My partner is very... very rigid. So if I was just like, babe, I don't get it, we have to watch it again, she'd be like, why are we watching the same episode again? She'd be like, yeah. Damn it, Karina.
I made you watch a little bit of season one.
Yeah. Yeah, you did. And it was actually really, really good. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to let you, since you are the expert, you're the subject matter expert.
I'm the expert. I'm the you're the SME.
Since you're on season two, we're going to have you explain season one, and then we'll explain, that's it. We'll just, you know,
yeah.
We'll talk about the differences.
Yeah. So for people who haven't seen The Ultimatum and you're queer or just kind of getting onto this bandwagon and you have not seen it and you're like, what the fuck is just happening in the trailer, right? Mm-hmm. Joanna's like, someone in your relationship has issued an ultimatum, like there are other people out here, and it kind of like went through it but not really. So to break it down, I'm gonna go through season one real quick so you have an understanding. Season one came out last year in April of 2022. It took place in Austin, and there were six couples. Now, these six couples have already been in a relationship for a significant amount of time.
Heterosexual couples, right?
Yes.
Male-female. Everybody was male-female.
Yes, everyone was male-female coupled. So they were already together for a significant amount of time. I think maybe the earliest was like 2 years, you know? But one of them's ready to get married, and then the other one not so much. So the person that wants to get married to the other person issues them an ultimatum. Okay. So essentially, they all get on the show. And all of these people, by the way, are professionally matched where there are compatible people within the relationship.
So like a psychology match or mm-hmm. like, okay.
Yeah. So they come on the show and essentially they all meet each other and then they then break up with their partner that night. And what they do is then for the next week or so, they're dating. The females are dating the males, and then the males are dating the females. And after the end of the week, they come down to the one person that they connect with the most, and your partner's off dating the same people. They're different people.
So you and your partner are off dating two different people. After a week has passed, you guys come together, and you matchmake who your new partner is going to be.
Your new partner.
And your new partner cannot be your current partner.
Your new partner cannot be your current partner.
Okay.
And that person is called your trial marriage partner. So you
cut a bitch so fast. Like I could never.
It was rough.
When we were watching season one, me and Jen, I would look at her and she was like, babe, and I'm like, I would fuck you up.
I will fuck you up. That's the
I'll fuck that bitch up first.
Comments on TikTok is so funny because they're just like, I could never. You know what the most funniest comment I've gotten was when someone's like, how did you get on the show? Please, like, I want to get on the show. I'm like, no, you don't, fam. No, you don't. She's like, I really do. I'm like, No, you don't.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, so you live with that person for the next 3 weeks.
Your new match
For the next 3 weeks to see if the grass is greener on the other side, to actually see maybe if you miss your partner, your original partner. It kind of creates a little bit more clarity. And then that could either go well or go really bad, depending on how you look at it and what else is going on with your partner, too. And then after those 3 weeks, you then swap back to your original partner. And you have a lot to go through. You have a lot to deal with.
You can learn a lot. You need a lot of therapy.
You can learn a lot, but something else could be going on too.
Yeah. So the idea is you go with this individual, you're dating them, you're falling in love with them, you're trying to figure out whether A, I want my current partner, not current partner, but the person you came into the show with, or B, you're gonna leave with somebody else. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't mean that just because I come to clarity that you're the person that I want means that you're gonna feel the same way when it's the 3 weeks are over.
Because I can be off, go be in a hoe bag or something, who knows?
Okay.
All right. So what happens then at the end, so to recap, you come in with a partner that you're already dating. You then split up. Then you all date other people.
Each other.
You then get a trial marriage partner. You live with them for 3 weeks. Then you go back to your original partner and try to hash things out for 3 weeks. And then it's decision day to figure out whether you're going to propose and get engaged or not. But so it's like shit or get off the pot.
So it's 6 weeks in total.
8 weeks.
8 weeks in total. Mm-hmm. So you
come in. 8 weeks.
Yeah, so the crazy part to me is coming back to dating your partner after A, you maybe just slept with somebody else, or mm-hmm. you were dating somebody else and you got intimate with somebody else. Like, how do you, if we came in with issues, like, I could never. That's just me. But that's what makes it so juicy, I think. Yeah. Like, if you came in with all of these issues and this conflict, and like, what is now going to be your resolution? Because it's not just him who dated somebody. She also dated somebody too. Mm-hmm. And so. Yeah.
And so, like, I could say.
But it doesn't count because you're not together.
Yeah. I could say I could never too, but no. I fucking did. And it. Like, I guess it's just do stuff that scares you. I don't know. But yeah. So the interesting part, so the only difference between season one and our season is A, it is all queer. So it's not male, female. It is female, female cast. And then I'm non-binary. But, you know, 9 out of 10 are female, female.
Okay.
So we're all dating each other. So think about this. Imagine this. Season one, uh-huh. 6 couples, 6 men, 6 women. They break up and start dating other people. Well, they can't date themselves and they can't date their original partner. So they're left with dating 5 potential matches. If you're a woman and you broke up with your man, you have 5 other men to consider dating.
Yeah, the women are off limits.
The women are off limits, yeah,
that's
straight.
Not what you identify as.
I mean, you know, maybe if they really try.
I mean, maybe, but like, you know.
On season one was bi, yeah. But there was no other bi
girls. Yeah, no
what
other
a shame.
Girls.
She should have been in our season.
She should have.
Anyway.
She's too early for her time.
Yeah. but with our season, mm-hmm. it is 5 couples. So it's actually 1 less couple than season one.
Than season one.
But the reason is because I can't date me and I can't date my partner.
Okay.
So then there are 8 other potential partners.
That you could, that physically, psychologically could match with.
Yeah, that I could possibly match with.
Because you guys are all women or non-binary.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever you identify as.
Yeah, so that they're, you know, so we date all the 8 people during the week. So we actually we have
so your percentage is a lot higher.
Yeah, yeah, a lot more possibilities and a lot more love triangles just in general if you think of it. Yeah. So it's a little crazy. And then season one takes place in Austin.
Mm-hmm.
And then ours takes place in San Diego.
We are San Diego bitches. I feel like I'm such a hype man. I don't ever tell everybody.
I'm the only
Florida.
One that lives in San Diego. And everybody, I'm like, meh.
Yeah. Well, it's funny though, because neither one of us are San Diego natives.
No.
But I feel like we rep San Diego pretty hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We rep San Diego.
I mean, we love the East Coast. Don't get me wrong. From the last conversation, y'all know we swear by the East Coast, but there's just something about the West Coast.
Yeah.
There's something in the air that Elon Musk is pumping out in these fucking Teslas. That's just, you know,
Well, it's not in the air. That would be like the gas, but the, you know, something that.
There's something.
Something that electricity.
Yeah, there's something running through here.
Something that AI.
But, all right, awesome. Okay, so that's the two shows explained. So you guys have more matches. You guys were based here out of San Diego.
Yeah.
And the goal is not to leave married. I don't know why I think that people keep talking about that. So
yeah.
The goal is just to A, either leave with your partner, engaged,
mm-hmm.
or leave with a new person. But are you leaving with a new person engaged?
Or leave there alone.
Or leave alone. So the potential options are, what are the 3 options? The
first either one? Leave. Or you either get engaged to the person you came in with.
Okay.
You leave with your trial marriage partner.
Okay. But are you engaged or do you just leave with them?
It's your
whatever
option.
You want. So to your discretion.
Yeah. But so yeah, to even come when the person, come engaged to the person that you showed up with.
Yeah.
So that's one. Yeah. To leave in a relationship or whatever it is, usies, with your trial marriage partner. Or just leave it alone.
Or leave there alone.
All y'all. I'm out.
So there's three options. And this was the same 3 options from season one. Doesn't change?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that does not change.
Okay, cool. But wait, the host changed though, right?
The host did change.
Okay, explain that. Yeah.
Yeah, so originally it's Nick and Vanessa Lachey. And there's a lot of controversy going on with them. They were like trying to sign petitions to get them off. That's the crazy thing. Y'all were signing petitions to get them off and like, you know, exile them from the show. Bitch, they already recorded season 5, 6, and 7, and I think 8. So even if you were to kick them off,
it wouldn't be till season 8.
That would be like 3-4 years from now. What the hell are y'all thinking?
Y'all just played yourself.
But anyway, so they have like nothing to do with our season. So
the queers.
So it is a franchise split off. So we're our own separate franchise.
Okay.
So we're going to talk about that.
So it's like if the Ultimatum had a love child and that love child came out as gay. essentially, right?
Like a redheaded stepchild?
Yeah, like a red, like you're the black sheep.
Yeah.
Oh, the queers are the black sheep.
Yeah. But no, Joanna is going to be the host for Queer Love and the Queer Loves to Come.
Wait, who's Joanna?
Joanna Garcia Swisher. She's going to be our host. Okay. She is our host.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so her, she's from Sweet Magnolias.
What other show is she from?
She's from Sweet Magnolias. Producer, production in the house. What's that?
Reba.
Reba. Production in the house.
Where else is she?
We got our own production team now.
Yeah, we got a production team.
What's that? We got one team. Over there, drinking Julie.
All right, perfect. So Reba.
Yeah, cool. Reba. And then she's so sweet.
All right.
So
sweet. Insert picture of her here. We'll show who she is.
She's beautiful.
Yeah. All right. Awesome. Well, if it takes place in San Diego, I'm assuming you guys hit up Hillcrest.
We did hit up Hillcrest.
You guys hit up Hillcrest. For those of you that don't know, like the non-San Diego people, the West Coast Hollywood people of LA. Yep.
I guess. Yeah. Lots of different like queer bars we went to and filmed into. Just a lot of queer representing people, businesses, everything like that. I really love how they used just even down to like production and the people on production and just like everyone that was involved. There were so many queer representing people. I loved it. Okay. I loved it.
Awesome. All right. Well, that being said, we are going to blind react to Two Dykes and a Mic.
Two Dykes and a Mic.
Because we love you guys and we thoroughly enjoy your content. And I just thought your shit was hilarious. So we're going to insert the video here.
Okay.
Flix's ultimatum is gay now. It's like the gay content gods have shone so brightly upon us. My prediction is not that anyone actually comes out married.
I agree. I think no one's going to get married, but by the end of it, they will form a rock climbing gym. They will form a business together.
They'll start an LLC.
Yeah, yeah, dude. I think at the end of it, they will actually form a 10-member cover band of Muna.
You mean Munas?
Yeah, it's gonna be Munas.
I don't think that they're gonna get married, but I do think they will all go back and forth ranking who has the strongest forearms.
That's the pilot episode.
Pilot episode is them flexing their forearms to each other and looking. Honestly, I bet that they plan and execute a full-on pickleball tournament.
Yes, the prize? Dillers.
Who's Diller? What?
Okay. All right.
There's first a lot of unpack.
Two Dykes and a Mic. We love you. We just love your content, period.
Yeah.
A couple questions. I think that's why we picked your video. A couple questions.
I know y'all are trying to make it funny, but at the same time,
it was for pure entertainment.
But I'm just like, I'm still processing that. I don't know if my IQ lowered a bit when I watched that.
No, I think we're from two different generations. So
yeah, different generations.
Completely two different generations. And yeah, and I'm just kind of like, I'm kind of confused. So, like, I think we were both confused on who the fuck is Muna?
Munas.
Who's Muna? Munas. I know Munas would be the queer ultimatum like cast on there, but what's, like, Muna? What is a Muna? Like, I tried Googling it. I'm like, what is Muna? The production team got a Pokemon. So we're thoroughly confused on what Muna is.
The production is also drinking Truly, so
yeah.
We don't know how valid that source is.
The pickleball thing, I get. Tiff does
pickleball,
not understand.
It's pickleball.
Pickleball is a game. Not pickleback. Pickleback is a shot.
Nickelback.
Nickelback is also white. But pickleball is like it's a very white game, and I only know this because I dated a girl in New Hampshire, Connecticut, whatever, where the fuck she, from up that way where they play pickleball. So,
is that like cricket?
No, it's like this game where you have like these two boards up and you have like a little circle thing on it and your whole goal is to throw it and get it on and like to latch on or to knock somebody else's string off of.
So kind of like cornhole?
It's like a cornhole but without bean bags and it's a long stick with two little like, I don't know, dick balls on it, and it's got like three layers, and you're just trying to either catch it on or drop somebody else's off.
That sounds toxic.
It's a
no wonder why it fits the fucking description. And then rock climbing, and then the forearms.
Yeah,
I think there's a stereotype that a lot of lesbians date other lesbians that like they both love to like Home Depot that shit and both love to like lumber and like, you know, like kayak lumber. And lift things up and put things down and like I like to date, me personally, I like to date women that like don't know the rules of football.
But see, I want to
like,
go pick
I like
up
that, like, you know, put on lots of makeup, go sports.
Like, but like, I want to pick up a girl at Home Depot. Like, that's the thing. Like, yeah. I want her picking out knobs for her kitchen and being
knobs.
Like, are you sure you want to go with copper or do you want to go with like gold because, you know, It's a classic look.
Yeah.
So
that's why.
But I like mass lesbians that way. Yeah. Like I want them to like get down and dirty.
But are you like that as well yourself?
No. Well, yeah. Okay. Dominique, production team. I feel like I'm very strong. I'm a fun, but I'm very like.
If we have to do it ourselves, we can do it.
If we have to do it ourselves, we can do it. So we're very dominant. We're very independent. But I don't want to do it. Yeah. I don't want to do it, but I can do it. And the older I get, I think the more feminine I get, only because I want to work smarter, not harder. So the hotter I look, the less shit I have to do, to be quite honest. And that's just pure intelligence working at this point.
Does that mean like the older that we get, like the more raggedy and like weathered hands we have?
But I'm Latina, so we age with like fine wine. Yeah, so that's
true.
That's the whole thing. Like,
that's true.
Also I'm gonna be, you know.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Yeah. Anyways, so back to forearms.
Back to forearms. I think I would win the forearm contest.
You like femmes. Yeah, you would win the forearm contest. I think the forearm contest. Yeah.
And then we don't know what the band Muniz is.
We don't know what Muniz is. I think I kind of get the LLC thing, but this is just me. Again, working smarter, not harder. I would be like, all right, bitches. We all got off of the queer love ultimatum. Like, let's all come together. Let's sign some NDAs. Let's sign some contracts together and form an LLC. And, like, let's capitalize the fuck out of Netflix because they're capitalizing on us. So let's, you know, turn the tables and capitalize on them too. Like, that's just where my mind goes. Like, I'm trying to create passive income. Like, let's create a podcast. Let's create merch. Let's do this. Let's do that. Like, that's just where my mind goes with the LLC comment.
Yeah, I feel you.
So
there's definitely. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I love the funny stereotypes. I've been watching, like, people's TikToks and people's Instagrams and reels. It's funny, the shit that people are saying. And I love it. I love it because people are so excited about it. However, the one thing I will say is that I think when you guys watch it, you're going to be very, very surprised about how much of these stereotypes do represent that, but how much also in different areas of our lives the stereotypes actually break down, and it's so normalized that can really, really relate to also to mainstream heteronormative society as well. Like, I love it. It's gonna be both. It's gonna be like, oh shit, that lesbian quote. But I feel like it's also going to be like, wow, this is like what average Bob and Wendy in Kansas,
Bob and Wendy,
who are open-minded, can watch and be like, you know what?
Like, I
can
get
this in Bob.
Like, I get it.
I can see this in Bob. And Bob's like, I can see this in Wendy. I can see like the same things happen in our relationship, which is a beautiful fucking thing all around. But obviously, we are going to get the lesbian representation.
Oh, 100%. But Two Dykes and a Mic, we loved your little snippet, your reaction to it. I think it's hilarious.
Laughter in this chaotic, stressful time.
100%. Yeah. We can't wait for you guys to react to the actual trailer release.
I hope so.
So, Two Dykes and a Mic, we're looking out for that. But we like those answered. Rock climbing. Muna. And we already explained pickleball. I think we're good on everything else. So, okay. Muna and rock climbing. We don't understand.
Yeah.
Help.
SOS.
Yeah, SOS, real quick. All right, but that wraps up. I almost said season one again. So we're manifesting.
We're manifesting.
All right, so that wraps up episode 5. And we will see you guys for episode 6.
Episode 6, baby.
See you later, Fweebies.
Bye, Fweebies.
Fweebs.